The first step in treating OSA is, of course, to diagnose it properly. This happens using a sleep study. An overnight polysomnogram would be a more formal term. And in this, a patient is going to go to an accredited sleep lab where a sleep technician will attach a series of electrodes and wires to the body that monitor things like respiration, abdominal force, eye movement, so we can track what sleep stage you're in. And of course, a breathing monitor and a camera. The most important part of the camera is it actually physically records somebody having an apnea. It's not uncommon for patients to know that they've awoken themselves by not breathing or to wake up and actually not be able to breathe and take a second to catch their breath. But for some patients, they have no concept of sleep apnea. They think they sleep just fine. It's their bed partner who can't handle the snoring and the sounds of the apneas and the wakenings who forces them to reach treatment. After the sleep study is executed, the doctor and sleep technicians will review the results with you. And at that point, it might warrant another sleep study, which we would call a CPAP titration. CPAP stands for continuous positive airway pressure. And it's basically one of the most naturalistic treatments you find in sleep disorder medicine. It involves taking a mask or nasal unit of some kind, which is connected to an air hose to a compressor. And essentially, this compressor, which is set at a pressure prescribed by the physician, is used to force air into the oral cavity and into the throat to expand the airway and prevent it from collapsing. There's any number of different masks and face units that can be used. It used to be in the early days of sleep medicine that CPAP choices were limited, and the discomfort of CPAP keeps people from seeking it as treatment. So in this day and age, we have so many more options, so many more people will stay treatment compliant and actually use their CPAP machine, which will lead to better sleep, better health. There's other treatments that can be used. For some people, an oral mandibular advancement device, which is a sort of dental appliance, may be an option. Although that's not indicated for everybody, it would be due to certain conditions in the mouth that lead to sleep apnea. There's also a type of surgery called a UPPP, which involves surgery on the uvula and soft palate on the throat. That's usually performed by a ear, nose, throat doctor. And again, that's not always an option for everybody, but those could be part of a treatment plan for OSA in particular patients.